Let me try something with you here. I think it's you next.
Ice climbers versus ice climbers.
Alright, so you're orange and blue, and I'm red and white. I don't care. FD?
Sure.
Usually this is ice climbers' best stage. Okay, I'm so focused on wave dashing, I'm not doing much of anything else. So down smash is really good, and even in neutral. So wave dash down smash is often your best approach. Alright, that's that one. Too far away. So, you know, one good thing about wave dashing is that you can do it out of shield, and that's how I've been trying to approach you a lot of these.
As ice climbers?
Yeah, so you can shield, and you can... that. That's also part of why I crawl the way that I do. Because you can... that's why I use L and R to wave dash out of shield. Although you're still winning, I'll have you know. You idiot! A little too low, it's a little too low. Yeah, this is a... it's like we have two very different skill sets, and if we somehow put ourselves together, we'd be good. But that's a... that's a thing. So, let's go into training mode, if that's alright by you.
Sure.
Actually, we had issues with training mode earlier. Never mind. How about... this is fine. Okay, so time with no time. So in other words, forever. That way we don't run out of lives. So, you know how to wave dash, of course, it's just kind of getting used to it is the trick. Ice climbers, I think, have the easiest timing in the game. I actually thought like this a lot more than Jigglypuff because their jump squat is tied for the shortest. And as you can tell, they can really get around the stage once you get it. My controller is messed up, my L button sticks a ton, and I'm still able to do all this. So, one of the reasons it's so good is it's your fastest, like, burst movement in the game. It's your fastest movement mode, and it sort of threatens people from, like, halfway across the battlefield. Once you get it real good, you can go a pretty far distance. Moreover, since you can jump out of shield, that means you can wave dash out of shield, because the first thing you do when you wave dash is you jump. So if a person does something that's unsafe on shield, even if they're a good distance away, like Marth, you can just respond by wave dash grab. You know. So, like for example, your hammer's pretty good. F smash my shield. You get the idea. Grab ledge. It also lets you turn around and grab the ledge pretty quickly instead of having to go through the actual whole jump. Yeah, it's a little bit risky at first when you're just getting used to it. Now, for the same reason that wave dashing is easier with them though, short hopping is harder. Marth has a 4-frame jump squat, but a 3-frame short hop window. Both of those numbers are reduced by 1 for ice climbers. So they're actually kind of hard to, you know what a short hop is, right? It's what I'm doing now.
How do you do it?
You just have to release the jump button really quickly. One way to do it is to sort of like roll off.
I see, yeah.
That's a little inconsistent until you get really used to it, because sometimes when you're doing something really technical, you might not reset right on the button. But I find it to be the easiest way. Of course, I'm Jigglypuff, so I could short hop if I... I mean, it's really easy with Puff, and Marth is right in the middle. But the reason that's useful is a lot of, so ice climbers are bad in the air. You may have noticed they have a lot of drift to their moves. Their moves are powerful, but not a lot of drift. They don't have a lot of drift. They're really slow in the air, so if you do a short hop, you get to the ground more quickly. Basically, you're super fast on the ground, but you're super slow in the air. Ironically, the only character that's faster on the ground and slower in the air than you is the same one, Luigi. This is the kind of thing that you can practice on your own, or you can do it here, or whatever. But, one of your best approaches, other than wobbling, is wave dash, down smash. That. Your hitboxes are really disjointed, so you can use that to your advantage. Like Marth's sword. You don't even technically need wobbling, although it helps a lot. And you shouldn't focus entirely on getting the grabs on people, even once you know how to wobble really well, because the percentage makes it harder for you to mash out. Battlefield. Nailed it. I honestly believe that if you can play Ice Climbers and Marth, then you can cover every matchup in the game. So Marth will cover Peach and Fox. Ice Climbers will cover everyone else. And Marth can also cover them too, like Falco. You could do Ice Climbers versus either of those. So there's some missing combos that look really cool, that once you get those down, they'll help a lot too. I'm not the expert on any stretch of the imagination, but like if you see people make Nana do the blizzard, but they're going forward with Popo, that's what they're doing. They use the blizzard to keep them stuck in shield, and then while they're stuck in shield, Popo can grab them. You have to desync them though when you do it, and that's the trick. I don't actually know how.
I don't know exactly how, but I can do it sometimes.
I mean, I kind of know how. There's some angle on the control stick. In fact, some ice climbers knock their controller so they can hit the angle all the time, where Nana will jump, but Popo will not, and so it automatically desyncs them. But it's a very specific angle. I don't even know exactly where to look for it.
I don't know how to make Nana do something as well as I know how to do something.
Yeah, she's slow. She's behind all the time. There we are. And I'm gone. Yeah, that'll do it. Alright, whenever you're ready. At this point, I'm just messing around. Alright. Now for my real name. Not at all. Not at all. This is my favorite character just for fun. Oh, yes! Let's do it! I don't care. Just pick wherever it works. Ready? Everything I just said about ice climbers, yeah. Amplify that by 100. Except that. Dash attack is awful. Ooh, the clank! That was cool. I imagine I probably get a lot more practice against foxes than you do against Luigi's.
Last time I played this with you.
Oh, that's good. And he happens to be one of the best people at Athens, so. Oh, I didn't have a jump! Yeah, that'll do it. It's around the light. Timing. Where you at? Frame 3, bro.
Do you know where to hit when I'm shielding?
Kind of. You can get shield poked, and that's something that you kind of just have to see. Like, if I watch how much you've been shooting, every now and then my butt will stick and I'll miss. Whoa! That doesn't work on the stage, Jay.
Oh.
Yeah. Misfire! So Luigi has a 1 in 8 chance when he does that move to misfire.
You just do it early.
Oh well, misfire means it goes further and deals 25% damage if it hits. That'll do it. Yeah.
Speaking of misfires.
Yeah, that's the short one.
Is that one how you double tap it?
Yeah, when you press it at in a certain window, you get different lengths for it. So Luigi's a lot of fun, but if my controller's not going to cooperate, I can't do that. I don't know. Pikachu. Pikachu doesn't use a lot of wave dashing. Wait. Party hat. Party hat, Pikachu. These are a bunch of special stuff. That'll work.
What was that?
Oh, dash dancing?
No, I mean, we like switched. That was weird.
Oh. No, she doesn't. She has a pretty big body relative to her shield. I mean, it comes with having that giant down smash, let's say. The opposite problem. I have T-Rex arms. Oh, that's a throw. That's a real throw. Strongest up smash in the game. Stronger than Fox's, maybe, for some reason.
Stronger than Zelda's?
Oh yeah, stronger than me. You have the most damaging down smash in the game. Although that requires getting hit by all of the hits for it. Yeah, that's what happens when you keep challenging it every time. Up there's a good move. Up smash is a better move, apparently. Very nice. It took me 83% to do it though, so not looking good. Dash attack. All, one of the strongest dash attacks in the game. That it is, man! Which is good. So I know that the way Pikachu is supposed to kill in this match is with up smash, obviously, but getting there is the trick. That'll do it.
It's kind of weird in this game. You don't want the high ground, you want to be below your opponents.
Yep, fair enough. I don't care. New stage we haven't been on yet?
Wait, this is different.
Oh, yeah. You know that Peach can do a flip, right?
Yeah. I just can't short hop that well, so I don't really do it unless I'm recovering.
For me, it's actually, and maybe this is because I claw, but the reason it's easier for me is because as soon as I jump, I press down, and that immediately gets me in this one that's like just above. Ooh! Okay, up smash. I didn't realize it reached on that platform. Yeah, that'll do it, I guess. The turnip re-grab. 91 all.
Yeah.
that beat my nair. Time to go turn it for me? Interesting. Jeez.
Daisy. You're channeling Daisy.
I'm the Daisy skin. I didn't know they had a separate one, though.
Maybe it's because it's in Japanese or something.
Maybe. She still shows up as Peach on the menu. Or maybe it's a translation thing and she's actually Daisy in Japanese.
And you, so in Japan they eat daisies and you look at peaches?
Well, yeah, you never know. It's Japan. Have you seen some of their shows, dude?
Yeah, exactly. You never know what the Japanese are thinking.
Oh my god! I mean, that button maker heavy. Whoa! Stitch! Was that a, that had to have been a stitch with that knockback. Box Y. Oh, turnip shenanigans. Oh my god. Okay, that was cool. Yes, Peach. She always sounds drunk.
Did I win? That was fun!
Lobotomized
by bouncers.
Something like that. So
that
she can never have
the real
power.
Sure. That'll work. Sweet. Oh, the true counter pick. I think we found the crash stage. Yeah, it
so
looks like we did.
You can't use that stage.
No, I'll switch over to vanilla melee. Keep that from happening again. Ay, ay, ay. Dang, man, that Peach. Georgia Peach. Nintendo. Alright, let's switch over to vanilla. Won't have all the cool training features, but, you know, we won't have that crash again. And we'll have more stages. And we're... No, we're still in Japanese, actually. Do I have hashtag Eva? Yes. Who's gonna be Samus?
Oh, right.
Oh, yeah, we can do this, whatever works.
That's okay.
Oh, oops. Thank you, Arwing! Arwing, why? Okay. That's how you know you're a real Samus, man. You miss. You fire and you miss.
Does that even hit you? Shield and kill him?
That's a good question. I don't think it... I think if Luke blocks it with his shield, he'll be fine if he's just standing still. Time up. Look how they change in Japanese. Time! Time up.
It's weird because it's in English.
But
yeah, why would they record different?
That's been a Japanese aesthetic for a while. I don't know. Oh, so I was going to be... Sheik? Blue Sheik? Congo Jungle? Oh, sorry. Sorry. You know,
I don't really like this stage. I think this might be like a
Yeah. Believe it or not, there was a time when this thing was turned into Tangle. Doesn't help its case. Apparently, Claptrap is a lot of the reason why it's not legal anymore, because sometimes you can go into the stage and fight, and sometimes Claptrap will get you. At a certain percent, that just, if you don't DI, it works. Sheik's a dumb character, and I know it. Sheik is, there's a reason Sheik gets a reputation for being a brain-dead character. Yes, thank you. Ivory Marth, the most regal of all. Nice. I can't even see what's going on down there. Whoa! That's... Little details like those make me remember why I love this game. Yeah. Oh, you wall tech there, by the way. Yeah, that's... I realized that when we were on the ship earlier. The saucer, I guess. And... there we go. It took till 200%, but... we got there, I guess. Just like I'm a real Marth now. F smash, F smash, F smash. Far enough back where I can't just short hop there and hit you. So you do know how to hold Mart or how to get you now.
How to hold the charge?
Yeah, so you can run around with it. But yeah, you already know that. So never mind. Also, Mart's sword is dumb.
Slice through buildings.
Apparently. Sometimes it seems a little unfair that a guy with just a sword is fighting people with lasers and missiles and psychic powers, and then you realize, oh wait a minute, no, he's actually broken. Oh. Oh. And then Marth does stuff like that.
Yeah.
Koopa! In Japanese he's Koopa. Oh my god. Nice. Let me get the biker Bowser. I like to think of him as being the one in the biker gang. This'll be good. So, if you play Bowser and your controller has Rumble on, every time he jumps, it's an earthquake. No! No! It is. I didn't see it coming per se, but I thought, you know, he's DI'ing in. There's a reason. Also, Bowser is the most. He has the slowest jump in the game because it takes him 8 frames to get to it. Oh my goodness! That should do it. Yeah, I don't have a jump. Oh! I didn't remember that was there! I hate Bowser.
Yeah. Just a big old hitbox.
Yup. There we go. That's something. I got one. Oh my god. I got one elf.
What? Oh. Okay, I don't know what happened there.
I think it burned your. Like, it gave you an extra jump there accidentally.
Well, I didn't jump very far either. I guess it stopped registering for some reason. So it was a very short jump. That didn't really register for some reason.
Trying to grab the ledge. It did not work.
My Kakiri shield would have burned up at the beginning of the fight.
Is that how that works? If only, man. Expand. Yes! These were evil characters, after all, in their respective games. That grab range is deceptively short, DK.
Ooh. The thing is, like, why does he have two really powerful charge attacks?
Well, what are the... I guess it's to try to get him to be distinguished from Captain Falcon a little bit. Best taunt in the game. Whoa, the no DI, that'll do it. Oh, that gap there. Oh, if then it works. You would have just won internet, my friend. Back in. Then of course it pushes you too far back for a follow-up. Oh my god! But, you know, we expand. That's what we do.
Expand? What does that mean?
It's just a joke about Donkey Kong. Expands the dome. I don't know why. It's just a good thing. Oh, get out of there! Ooh, no, not like this!
No vertical.
Not like this! Never got to do one cargo throw. Rip. Rip Donkey Kong. The manliest man of them all. He has an 8-pack. I mean, that'll work.
Why not?
I mean, it's Falcon.
Oh yeah.
I must not know the knee's timing. This stage is dumb. I know it. Ooh! I got under the road!
I've never seen that.
Okay. Big Blue giveth and Big Blue taketh away, I suppose. I swear, I must have the worst. There's a knee! It only took me about 16 tries. And then he gets two in a row. That's how this works. There you go.
You can't even see the course from your opponent.
Cheeky down smash. You do that! Like I got on the Batmobile. Yo! This stage. Can we try that on a different stage?
Okay.
That's alright. Yeah. We haven't been on Hyrule yet.
I haven't been on Hyrule yet. Ready?
Go! Oh! We're fighting as if we don't have the biggest stage in the game. It is a tiny little. Okay, we don't die off the top. Show me your moves. There we go. That'll do it.
219.
Thank you. what Nintendo Power called the Fight Pen in Fight Club. It's a pinball machine down there.
I guess his arms are too short.
Yeah. He's got what Pikachu has apparently. Nailed it! Not what I was going for.
So Yoshi's Egg covers the whole thing.
Yes, he cannot be shield poked. But to make up for that, he also can't jump out of the shield. Which in competitive play is awful because he can't wave dash out of the shield. But, again, can't be shield poked. Jeez. And suddenly 148%.
Dinosaurs are known to get those guys.
Yep. And you got it.
No, I
Whoa!
Don't!
I didn't mean that to be cheeky. I thought you actually did.
I thought so too.
And there we go. Dash attack. Oh, Yoshi. How I love you. I don't know. I picked the last one. I think I picked the last two, actually. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me once, you can't fool me with you. Please tell me you know what that's a reference to. Yep. I did not. That could have actually been kind of cool if that gave me a cheeky way to get behind you. Kirby combos. Wow. my god, you're so slow! I'm trying to parry, I'm trying to shield drop. Yeah, I'm a little too tall for that, or a little too short for that. And up air for, it looks like Sheik, but it's really more of a combo tool than actually kill you. It racks up damage, like, I don't believe though. Okay. I will hit that. Dash attack. Of all of the moves, dash attack.
Such a strong.
Yeah, with Samus they are. It's weird to say that it seems like Kirby's tilts actually do more than smash attacks. I'm not even joking. Like that. What on earth with that? True, but Kirby's smash. Oh! Kirby's smashes are trash. Smash 4 combos. Am I not going to be hit by a car at some point?
Keep forgetting.
Hi. I'll stop. Oh, the bird. Chain Grand City. Oh yeah, this is Falcon. So I'm used to playing Jigglypuff where I can either jump over your lasers or I can crouch them. I'm not used to having to actually deal with lasers. So, normally you want to do your short hop lasers because your laser, wow, actually land cancels. So, when you hit the ground with it, You just jump and laser. That's all you gotta do. Just jump and press B. Yep. And it'll cancel the animation when you hit the ground. Yeah, just like that. And the reason that's good is it lets you move while you approach. Move back, move forward, whatever. Oh my god!
Take!
a reason why it's the pool noodle that he's using. Marth has a sword of legend, Roy has a pool noodle. What were you about to say?
I think I can win this year in the 6th. Because he moves when he...
Yeah.
And like, it's so fast, it's so much faster than Roy's attacks.
Just a lot. Roy is a terrible character.
He used to be my absolute favorite.
Mine too,
for the same reason, like 2004. You win just using the C6.
Yep. Oh yeah. I picked the last one. Okay. In before, I get 9 about 8 times.
I go for the bacon. I'm more of a bacon.
Oh, so no, you say that.
I did remind
it
you
was
of
a bait!
So I can fill this bucket up with your magic, right?
Yes.
And then throw it back at you.
That works on any projectile in the game, I think. Scrub. Wax on, wax off. Get that tech in, or I'm dead. Mewtwo is surprisingly light.
Wow.
Also, that is a thing. So, Game & Watch's strongest move is his Nair. It's kind of like his version of Captain Falcon's name.
It's
yeah, exactly.
It hits above him?
It does. It does weirdly enough for a Nair hit above him, but if you can hit with it, it's... Again, it's Captain Falcon's knee on Game & Watch.
Oh.
Yeah, that was me crouching and teching for trying to tech. So... Ooh.
Does it only be down when it's full?
Yes. It needs to get 3 charges, and then it can actually be a move. It'll be a move. And if those 3 charges are Fox Lasers, it's not... all that useful.
Oh, so it remembers the damage.
Yes. So the strongest move in the game, apparently, is if you use the bucket on 3, I think, fully charged Samus beams, the plasma cannon, and then you have that counter with Roy. Yeah, because Roy's, Marth's counter does a flat 7%. Roy's is actually based on the damage of the original move. Man, that F smash. Oh my. Thank you, Bullet Bill. A bonsai bill, I guess, the big one. Also, I don't really know how to... I know how to do these double jump characters. I just haven't really, like, ingrained it. Where if you put an attack in for the double jump, you can cancel. Yeah, like that. I'm dead. Yeah, the usual follow-up to that is Nair.
Yeah, it's fine. I'm still pressing up.
Yeah, and at that percent, it's kind of hard anyway.
that's your neutral.
Yeah, it's a surprisingly short. It deals a decent amount of damage if all the hits connect, but oh my god, that was crazy. Oh, what would that have been?
Who knows?
The world may never know.
Does it save over different lives?
That's a good question.
I think it does. It must have.
Apparently, because it looked like it would have another one in it. Oh. Also, his, you just saw, his up B is one of the highest vertical recoveries in the game. Oh, that was it! Oh, let me just give you a platform to come back. Yeah, box. I'll take it.
It's bacon proof.
It's a hungry box, man. I had to. I feel as if I was contracting, so you can't hit the same number within the next two. So if you hit 9, the next two can't be 9. But then thereafter.
Oh my god, 8%. No, I have a 1 in 9 chance.
1 in 7 chance, because it can't be the last two.
Well, I just did it twice, and it was a 9.
So then it's a 1 in 7, because it won't be what you just
oh,
got.
Oh, I see.
Boom!
Damn, that button. No.
It gave me hope, and then it just shattered. I'll be Falcon again, I guess. You gave me random. You wanna do random v Ramport? Ness works. Bumblebee. Oh yeah. Sure. Because when you think Captain Falcon, you think F smash into F smash. There we go. That's more like it.
I wish it would explode, even if you broke concentration.
Doesn't it in Project M? You think? Have you ever gotten the chance to play that game?
I have. I really like it.
Me too. Actually, Blasphemy of All Blasphemies, I prefer it to Melee. Just because, if no, I mean, even though my character is... Ooh! I was going for that knee there. Even though Jigglypuff is much worse in Project M, not worse, just relative to the lobby casting, I just prefer the better metagame, more characters, more viable sort of thing. That's just me.
Yeah, also, more viable characters definitely better.
There's a guy in Brazil that has another channel that plays. He actually plays PM, and at some point I'd like to get the chance to play against him. Jigglypuff versus, he plays Lucas. I don't even really know what the difference between Lucas and Ness is, other than... what is it, your up B goes through people if you're Lucas, I guess? I think that's what I remember. Oh my god! That was... Okay. The stomp. You have your own stomp, apparently. Falcon Punch. So the new national taunt has to be the Falcon Punch. Okay, bad timing. I don't know what to do with characters that are fast on the ground and slow in the air. I don't know what to do with my life. So, if you're playing Ness against someone and they're just hanging on the ledge, your bat will actually hit below the ledge. So, if they're just hanging there, waiting it out, nope, they're in for a rude awakening. I found that bug, by the way.
I don't know.
Absolutely break your shield. That is impossible.
That should be impossible to hit. That should, I mean, impossible to block, I meant. Sakurai, why?
Because, like, if the hitbox is that entire thing, then wouldn't it at least have, like, shield poked you?
I think that if it collides with the shield on the same frame, that it counts as hitting the shield. Let me get that bug off. There we go, bro. Oh, okay. I just did random. Venom. Okay. The two wave dash characters in the game. Nana, why?
Very natural.
No, one of the worst dash attacks in the game. Because you can crouch it to like forever. Okay.
Dash attack.
I know. Well, I would say jumps, but yeah, Luigi's a good character. He just has his style. He doesn't really play outside of that style too well. No amount of DI is saving me from that one. And what you're doing right there is why the stage is banned in competitive play. People hiding under the wings. Well, you know,
it's a good place to wait.
It is. They call that a cave of life. What has this become? Nana, don't be a hero! lobby there because the mana, not the lead. It does have to be the lead. Oh! Serving the pizza. $2 slices. That is kind of... Okay. Oh!
What was that?
So Luigi has... When he does his up B, normally it just does this little coin damage.
Yeah.
It like knocks a coin out of him 1%, not much. But if you hit them with the first frame and you hit them with the sweet spot, it's like a Shoryuken. And
yeah,
it's super
I know
powerful.
About that. Why did I fall instead of grabbing the ledge?
Luigi's up B doesn't do any horizontal, and you weren't quite close enough to the edge. It's dumb.
It looked like I didn't go. Like, I feel like if I didn't hit you, I would have gone.
Ganondorf is actual. Okay, fine. He's actual my least favorite character in the game. Oh, Bowser. I just don't like big dumb characters. Yeah, you can do something other than Peach if you want. I was just random and for random. Dreamworks. It's a, this is actually canon.
Arena. It's a
well, yeah. Fun fact, Ocarina of Time, the secret true ending, actually takes place in Dreamland. Okay, so apparently that's a thing. No, it's not. It looked like it. Have I mentioned I hate Ganon?
Yes.
Oh. I thought I would have grabbed the ledge naturally. I'm gonna get four-stalked by Zelda! Not even Sheik! Zelda! Yep! Four-stalked. Wrecked. New tier list.
Yeah, Ganon's... I think that's the same tier list.
Ganon's at the bottom. I would rather play Kirby, if I had to. You know what? We haven't been on Pokéfloats yet.
Okay.
This abomination used to be tournament legal.
Stationary.
Onix evolved to Steelix. I mean, this is more than just Gen 1. This is Gen 2. Steelix was Gen 2, I think.
Gen 2, yeah.
There's Chikorita. There's Evangeline's Chikorita. So on 20XX, or not. 20XX, there's a color swap for this stage where they're all shinies. Ooh! That, I was pretty sure would have done it. No! Okay! Yep, if you're hit in that last hitbox, you're gone. Come on, Wooper! Come on, Wooper! Wooper, save me! Evan knows I need it. I'm still Kirby. Well, you're Zelda, so. No tear Johns, I suppose. Yeah, Zelda's smash attacks aren't a joke.
Is Seal the second gen?
I think he's first, because I think I remember having one from Wabba Wabba for a while. Good to see you, Wabba
Fett.
Okay. Oh, okay, he's being Wabba Fett. Goldeen is about to, yeah. Get over here! It may be a different fighting game.
See?
Oh! Genius that I am. Oh my god! Okay, that was...
That was fun.
This stage gets infinitely better when you can play a character with some real mobility. You blew Yoshi. Your call. Okay, we're on a legit stage for once. The noggin flogging.
Break out of it as early as I can.
I don't think I could have done it that soon. At that percent? Because it is percentage based.
Oh, ho, 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 ho.
Both of our attacks missed there. That was crazy, but that works. So you know Yoshi has armor in this game, like Guile, right? So armor means you'll still take damage, but you don't actually take knockback. You don't get knocked anywhere. When Yoshi does his second jump, when you hear him go, like, do that, he's actually not invincible, he'll still take damage, but he doesn't take knockback until he gets to a high percent. And you can use that to help you recover. That's how they tried to balance Yoshi's recovery. We're only gonna give him two jumps, no, like, up B to get him back, because the egg doesn't really gain that high, but to make it easier, we'll give him armor. Except that players like Omsa have figured out how to use that in battle.
Your Jigglypuff is very frustrating.
I'm sorry. I know it. I'm a Puff man. Let me not do Puff again. Ooh. Ooh. This setup, man. This setup. Ready? It was supposed to be a down tilt. That was so dumb. I knew it was gonna happen. Not exactly a tipper. I know no Johns, but there is actually a bug on the screen. Sorry, bug. I had to go for it. Do it. I'm sorry. Not like this. Not like this. Hey, can we do one more, like, serious one, and then we can play magic? That's okay?
Sure.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Marth Ditto? We haven't Marth Ditto'd this whole time.
Didn't we once?
I don't think so.
We can do that. FD?
Yeah, whatever works. FD's good. Keep trying to challenge that. It's not been working out.
Okay. Another jump.
Okay, Mart's way dash is like the coolest thing. And we actually started the match off with two stocks, apparently. Now it won't do it at all for me. Okay. Tipper. Missed the sweet spot.
Oh, that's always just on the move, isn't it?
Yeah. F Smash is his farthest reaching move. Marth is weird.
Alright, magic?
Magic!